While Apple doesn't allow VPN apps to be installed directly on their Apple TV platform, there are three popular methods to change your perceived location on the streaming device. The problem is, despite all the how-to videos that you can find on YouTube, one of these methods simply does not work anymore. And that's despite testing it with six different services that I'm subscribed to. So anyway, I'm gonna share with you each of these three methods and then show you how I personally use it on my new second generation Apple TV 4K. Welcome to All Things Secure, my name's Josh, and since I live in Asia right now, the only way that my family and I are able to watch our favorite shows, movies, and sports on Apple TV is by tricking the device into thinking that we're in a different location. Now, ethically, I don't have a problem with this at all since I'm a paying subscriber to any service I'm using, be that Netflix, YouTube TV, Disney Plus, or others. Also, nothing that I'm about to show you will require any hacking of your Apple TV or anything else that would void the warranty. We're simply faking our location. You can use the chapter markers on this video to jump to a specific section, but I'm gonna start by sharing the only method that has reliably worked for me and then two other methods that you can try if you want to. If you've used a commercial VPN before, you know that most of the time you install an app on your device and then connect that device to a VPN server through the app or some sort of settings configuration. Unfortunately, no such app exists for your Apple TV, so you have to move up that data chain just a little bit and configure the same VPN connection on your Wi-Fi router instead. By doing this, now all the devices that connect to that Wi-Fi box are routed through whatever VPN server you configured it for. So if I've set up a Los Angeles server on my home Wi-Fi router, now any device, including gaming consoles, Internet of Things devices, and even my Apple TV, are connecting to the internet through that Los Angeles server. Before you get too excited about this method though, let me give you a quick warning. If you're using the Wi-Fi router that your internet service provider gave you, this probably isn't going to work. You're gonna need to spend a little bit of money to upgrade to an additional router that allows you to configure a VPN connection. And if you need some help picking out a good VPN router that does this, I've listed a few in the description below this video. The setup process is slightly different for each router, but in general, we can break it down into three steps. First, you need to log into your router, and the instructions to do that are usually printed on the back or the bottom of the router itself. For my Asus router, I simply make sure that I'm connected to the router via Wi-Fi or Ethernet cable, and then type in router.asus.com into my browser. But once you've logged in, you need to find where you can set up a VPN configuration. And honestly, it shouldn't be too hard to find. If you don't see it anywhere, there's a chance that your router doesn't support VPNs, and your options are to either buy a new router or to do what's known as flashing the router, which is basically adding a new operating system to the device. Now, I'm not gonna show you how to do that here, and I only recommend it if you know exactly what you're doing. Step two, now that we're inside the router, is to grab the configuration files from your VPN. Now, I'm using ExpressVPN for this example, and they've worked great for me out here in Asia. If you'd like to give them a try, you can visit vpnsetupguide.com, which is an affiliate link that also helps to support this channel, so thank you. Any VPN you use, though, will have some kind of setup page where you can find manual VPN configuration files. You'll likely want to use OpenVPN, which will require you to download a .ovpn file. As you can see here on ExpressVPN, I click on Manual Configuration. I choose the server from the country that I want to trick my Apple TV into thinking that I'm in, which in this case is the United States, and then I download that file that it gives me. Step three is to add this to my router. Back in my router's VPN settings, I'm gonna add a configuration and make sure that I'm doing OpenVPN. I'll then set it up, I'll give it a name that helps me know which location it is. I'm gonna have to copy and paste the username and password from the ExpressVPN website or whatever VPN you're using, and then I'll upload that .ovpn file that I downloaded for the server that I want. You can create a number of different locations as you see that I've done on my router. So if one doesn't work well, or if it just happens to be slow for some reason, I can change and easily go to a different server. Now that setup is complete, I simply turn on a VPN connection, either directly through my computer or with Asus, I can actually download an app on my phone or iPad to make it faster, and then make sure that my Apple TV is connected to that particular Wi-Fi router. And I'm good to go. I stream sports, movies, and even YouTube TV using this configuration. The only downside to this router method is the actual cost of the router itself. If you don't want to spend the money on a new router, you can try one of the next two methods I'm about to share with you. The second method is the mirror method. Let's say you're using an iPad or iPhone and you have a VPN app already installed on there. If you connect to the VPN and then pull down from the top right corner of your device, you'll see this double box icon that might even have the text screen mirroring next to it. If you don't see it, make sure you're connected to the same Wi-Fi network as your Apple TV. Now, here's the rub. If I open up a dedicated app on my mobile device for a streaming service, for example, the Netflix app or the Disney Plus app, and then I try to mirror my screen onto the Apple TV, it doesn't seem to work for me. Apple seems to recognize that I'm using an app, and then it tries to run the streaming through that same app on the Apple TV that isn't using a VPN, and so I end up getting some kind of error message. What does work, at least more often for me, is to sign into these streaming services through a mobile browser while I'm connected to a VPN on my device. Now, when I play through the browser on my iPhone or iPad and then mirror that onto my Apple TV, it actually mirrors what's happening on my device instead of trying to run it through its own connection. The benefit here is that I can actually watch it on my TV. The downside is that the quality often isn't amazing. A side note here before I move on to the last method is that if all else fails, you can always just connect your VPN-enabled computer or iPad directly to your TV to stream whatever you want to watch. I mean, that completely negates the purpose of having an Apple TV, I realize, but I also know that if you're using this video to troubleshoot and you just want to start watching your show right now, this might be your best option. Finally, the one method that has caused me the most frustration. You might have seen that your VPN service offers a feature known as SmartDNS, or there are actually some standalone SmartDNS services. SmartDNS is different from a VPN because it only redirects your Apple TV's domain name server queries and not all of the internet traffic. And since you're not encrypting all of your traffic, it's supposed to be a lot faster for streaming or gaming or other things. That is, if you can actually get it to work. I've spent the last week testing out SmartDNS services from ExpressVPN, CyberGhost, NordVPN, Surfshark, and others, and not a single one has worked for me. Not for Disney Plus, not for Netflix, not for anything that I want to stream. The problem is the sheer number of fail points here. You have to register your IP address, or wait, you might need to register for a dynamic DNS hostname instead. And if that doesn't work, you might have to disable IPv6 on your router. And if that doesn't work, you have to contact your internet service provider and ask them to turn off IPv6. I promise you, I did everything I could and I never got SmartDNS to work with any of the services I subscribe to. That's not to say it's impossible. I'm sure there might be something that I did wrong and you could get it working. But I want to encourage you that if it doesn't work for you, you're not alone. If I were you, I would focus instead on adding a VPN to a Wi-Fi router or mirroring my mobile device to the Apple TV. You'll have a higher chance of success and you won't go through all the frustration that I had to. Which method worked best for you? Leave a comment with any tips for others who are doing the same thing. Give this video a like, and if you need a new VPN for this process, jump on over to vpnsetupguide.com. Thanks for watching.